Welcome to Biomass Magazine's top headlines from the past week. I'm your host, Jill Nelson. Join us November 12th and 13th for the North Dakota Energy Conference and Expo taking place in Grand Forks, North Dakota. Exhibit space is now available. Visit ndenergyconference.com to learn more. Representatives of the renewable natural gas industry are urging the U.S. EPA to increase the cellulosic RVO in its final rule to set 2020 blending obligations under the renewable fuel standard. The public comment period on the rulemaking closed August 30th. The Coalition for Renewable Natural Gas and stakeholders in the RNG and waste industries filed comments on the proposed rule urging the EPA to set the gaseous fuels portion of the cellulosic RVO at a minimum of 650 million gallons to incorporate all the RNG produced and available next year, including production from more than 36 new facilities that are currently under construction. Also, the National Biodiesel Board urged the EPA to increase the advanced biofuel RVO for 2020 and the biomass-based diesel RVO for 2021 to accommodate domestic biodiesel and renewable diesel producers' proven ability to increase output. U.S. exports of wood pellets fell in July. Data published by the USDA Foreign Agricultural Service on September 4th shows the U.S. exported more than 451,000 tons of wood pellets in July, down when compared to the 694,000 tons exported in June and the 476,000 tons exported in July 2018. The U.K. was the top destination for U.S. wood pellets in July, followed by the French West Indies, Canada, Italy, and the Netherlands. Read more in our online coverage. The U.S. EPA posted a notice to its websites September 4th announcing a memorandum of understanding with the Internal Revenue Service, under which the agencies have agreed to share information in effort to identify and respond to fraud related to renewable fuels. Under the MOU, the EPA and IRS will share information about fuel production facilities and fuel program compliance to facilitate policy development, market understanding, data verification for renewable fuel credits, identification and reduction of renewable identification number fraud in support of Renewable Fuel Standard Program Administration, and identification and reduction of fuel tax fraud in support of Federal Tax Administration. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back next week with more of the biomass industry's top stories.